Morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today being a Saturday, we offer this Eucharist in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our Mother. Let us ask for her continuing intercession and motherly care, especially for those who are sick and those who are terminally ill. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pardon the faults of your servants, we pray, O Lord, that we who cannot please you by our own deeds may be saved through the intercession of the Mother of your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, what is the meaning of this proverb that you recite in the land of Israel? Fathers have eaten green grapes, thus their children's teeth are on edge. As I live, says the Lord, I swear that there shall no longer be anyone among you who will repeat this proverb in Israel. For all lives are mine. The life of the father is like the life of the son. Both are mine. Only the one who sins shall die. If a man is virtuous, if he does what is right and just, if he does not eat on the mountains, nor raise his eyes to the idols of the house of Israel, if he does not defile their neighbor's wife, nor have relations with a woman in her menstrual period, if he oppresses no one, gives back the pledge received for a debt, commits no robbery, if he gives food to the hungry and clothes the naked, if he does not lend at interest nor exact usury, if he holds off from evil doing, judges fairly between a man and his opponent, if he lives by my statutes and is careful to observe my ordinances, That man is virtuous. He shall truly live, says the Lord. But if he begets a son who is a thief, a murderer, or lends at interest and exact usury, this son certainly shall not live. Because he practiced all this abomination, he shall truly die. His death shall be his own fault. Therefore, I will judge you, house of Israel, each one according to his ways, says the Lord. Turn and be converted from all your crimes, that they may be no cause of guilt for you. Cast away from you all the crimes you have committed, and make for yourselves a new heart, a new spirit. Why should you die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of anyone who dies, says the Lord God. Return and live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. I will teach transgressors your way, and sinners shall return to you.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humbled. O God, you will not spurn.
Create a clean heart in me, O God. Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Children were brought to Jesus that he might lay his hands on them and pray. The disciples rebuked them, but Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not prevent them. For the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." After he placed his hands on them, he went away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
No reason was given in the Gospel why the disciples prevented the children from coming to Jesus. Perhaps the disciples saw that the Lord is tired or was tired, that they wanted the Lord to have some rest. But here in the Gospel, my dear brothers and sisters, it shows that people for the Lord, especially children, are more important than personal rest. Marahil pagod ang Panginoon, pero para sa Panginoon, ang mga tao ay mas importante kaysa sa kanyang pagpapahinga. That is why the Lord allowed the children to come to Him. And according to this gospel, He placed His hands on them, blessed them. Siguro kung kultura na ng mga Hudyo nung araw, ang pagmamano, baka hinayaan ni Jesus na magmano ang mga bata sa kanya. So, there are two things that I would like to point out in this gospel. Number one, as our reflection, do we prevent people to come to Jesus? By our words, by our attitude, by our action. Do we become the hindrance, the obstacle for people to come nearer to the Lord? Tayo bang nagiging dahilan, nagiging sagabal para ang mga tao ay masigit na makilala ang Panginoon? Kayong mga altar servers, no? I welcome you because this morning you will have your ongoing formation. Kayo'y mga taong simbahan. Tayo ay mga taong simbahan. Meron na ba kayong naakay? Nakaibigan? Para mag-serve sa Panginoon. O baka naman kumisan nagiging exclusive ang grupo nyo. That can happen, no? That we in the church sometimes form an exclusive club to the point that others who are outside the exclusive club are not allowed to come in. Meron tayo dito sa lalo na sa Metro Manila, meron tayong tinatawag na gated subdivisions. For their protection, you cannot just enter into the subdivision. You need the sticker. You have to show your ID, license. But sometimes, that is what prevents people from entering into the place. That is the first thing that we should ask ourselves. Are we, like the disciples, preventing people to come near to the Lord? The other reflection is this. Jesus blessed the children. Are we also source of blessing to others? By our words, by our attitude, by our action. Tayo ba ay nagiging instrumento ng pagpapala? Tayo ba ay nagiging instrumento ng inspirasyon? Gumagaang ba ang pakiramdam ng ating kaibigan, kasama sa paglilingkod dahil sa ating mga magandang sinabi? We should be blessings to people. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, as we continue in this Eucharistic celebration, let us ask for two graces from the Lord and from the Blessed Mother. First, that we may not be the cause of scandal to other people, that they turn away from God, from the church. And secondly, let us pray that we may always be a source of blessing and inspiration to others, especially to those who are not still yet part of the Christian community. Kasi kuminsan, nahahati tayo eh. Taong simbahan. Tayo, mga taong simbahan. Yung iba, hindi taong simbahan. Sana dumating ang araw na lahat ay maging taong simbahan. Amen.
Please all stand.
With confidence we come and present our needs to God our Father who loves all His children as we say, Let your hand be upon us, Lord.
Let your hand be upon us, Lord.
That the Church of Homes may be built on unselfish love and that families may know and understand the depths of God's love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your hand be upon us, Lord.
That married couples may be sensitive to each other's needs and find true happiness in their lives together. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your hand be upon us, Lord.
That parents may bless their children with attention, caring, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your hand be upon us, Lord.
That children and those who are considered weak in our society may be supported by those who have more in life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your hand be upon us, Lord.
That eternal peace be granted upon those who have died. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your hand be upon us, Lord.
Father, your kingdom belongs to little children. Hear the prayers of your children who trust in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please all stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, the offerings we bring you, and grant that enlightened by the Holy Spirit and encouraged by the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our hearts may always seek out and treasure the things that are yours, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
As one family, let us pray to our common Father in heaven in the words Jesus himself gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation and of faith, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that we, who devoutly honor the Blessed Virgin Mary, may be worthy to share with her in the charity of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.